This is a summary of the CPIC dosing guideline for tacrolimus and variation in the gene CYP3A5. This guideline was published in July 2015. Due to the reduced chance of CYP3A5 normal or intermediate metabolizers reaching target concentrations of tacrolimus using standard dosing, the guideline recommends an increased starting dose in these patients. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB tacrolimus and cyclosporin pharmacokinetic pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Tacrolimus is an immunosuppressant used following solid organ and hematopoietic stem cell transplantation. It is metabolized in the intestine and liver by CYP3A4 and CYP3A5. This metabolism inactivates tacrolimus. In CYP3A5 poor metabolizers, the metabolism of tacrolimus is decreased. This causes CYP3A5 poor metabolizers to have a better chance of reaching target tacrolimus concentrations with standard dosing compared to CYP3A5 normal or intermediate metabolizers. There are currently 9 defined alleles of CYP3A5, known as star alleles. A CYP3A5 allele definition table, along with other gene information tables for CYP3A5, can be accessed at the PharmGKB website or by using the link in the description below this video. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 allele, which is designated as a normal function allele. Diplotypes of CYP3A5 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. In contrast to other drug metabolizing enzymes, CYP3A5 poor metabolizers are common in many populations. As an example, 80 to 85% of Caucasians are CYP3A5 poor metabolizers. Note that as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that a normal function status is given to all alleles which are not detected in the assay. This can include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for tacrolimus. Patients with a CYP3A5 normal metabolizer phenotype will have a decreased chance of reaching target tacrolimus concentrations with standard dosing. These patients should be given an increased starting dose of tacrolimus. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with a CYP3A5 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have a decreased chance of reaching target tacrolimus concentrations with standard dosing. These patients should be given an increased starting dose of tacrolimus. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with a CYP3A5 poor metabolizer phenotype will have an increased chance of reaching target tacrolimus concentrations with standard dosing. These patients should begin therapy with the recommended starting dose. This is a strong recommendation. The dosing recommendations for tacrolimus can be found in Table 2 of the guideline. Detailed footnotes pertaining to the recommendations can be found at the bottom of this table. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to tacrolimus, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injuries to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.